Let me go ahead and switch over to a branch that has our verifications included, and I'll show you just how easy it is to start writing tests once you have a good framework set up. Okay, so you can see here we have a few more verifications. We have a new method to our data object that calls verify saved data, and what that will actually do is take the expected data that is built from our test data. When we save a file, it'll set properties on this object to the path that it's saved to, and then it will actually verify that the full contents of the file matched what you typed in. So for part of that, we also added in some verify that the files are saved inside of our save dialog and save to file scripts. It sets properties of the data object that we have, and then it returns it again. So I will show you here just kind of how easy it is to write a test if you need to write a new test. All you have to do is drag over some options. So we'll open Notepad. We will get test data. We're going to get test data that is a type of company. And if you remember, that returns the test data object. We're going to do another actions, and we're going to say input test data. And for the data object, we are going to say that is the last result, which was the test get test data. And we're also going to say true on this clear option. So basically what that's going to do is it will clear out anything that is currently in Notepad, in case there is. And then we're also going to say verify. And it will say true to that. And basically what that's going to do is everything we type in there, it's going to verify that it shows up on screen correctly. And then for our last action for this test, we will do menu navigation. And what was the option I gave for that? Where did it go? So menu navigation. And it's just exit. That makes sense. So that brings me actually to another point that I want to make. If you noticed it, even for me who wrote this, sometimes it gets a little tricky remembering where certain things live, what they do, what you need to call to do certain actions on your application. So I highly recommend either building your own or using some kind of free open source tool to generate documentation. I actually use one that's called ESDoc. All you have to do is, if you have Node.js installed, it's an NPM package. And what it does is it'll parse your block comments and give you a nice clean web page for documenting all of your framework utilities. So like you, I saw here, I mentioned earlier, the menu navigation. So it will say, hey, where the option is, and it's from the nav options object. So you can see here that we have exit and save. So within very little time at all, I've created a test here that will actually open up Notepad, get test data from our test database, and put the data in, and exit the test. So if you see here, I actually still have that pop-up up. So that's because I forgot to, let's see, where did I not put that in yet? So actually, I shouldn't have done the full nav option. I should have done close Notepad, because if you see here, it has a default of bypassing the save dialog. So let's go ahead and remove that guy and do close dialog or close Notepad. And if we run that again, it should actually close for us. There we go. So let's do a fun little test here. Hopefully it'll work for me better than it did this morning when it didn't work for me. So let's say we just got a new version of the application from dev. And for the purpose of this demonstration, I'm going to say that the new version is just Notepad++. And so we actually set our environments with Windows environment variables, like I said before. And so just to kind of show an example here, here's what Notepad++ looks like. Here's what Notepad looks like. Looks like we're probably not going to be able to run the same test we just created, right? So let's try it and see how it works. And there we go. Same test, completely different application, changes were made to it, but because we've set everything right up from the get-go, we're still verifying the functionality of the app. You can see it's still putting in the keyboard, it's still verifying that the everything matches what we want. Same test exactly, completely new version of application with changes. We didn't even have to update anything except our environment config.